this afternoon, it's the long-term benefits of having an active creative economy are massive, especially for emerging nations. Creativity in all its forms is our most powerful asset as human beings. It's far, far more powerful than our ability to destroy, believe you me. And it's creativity that will bind us together as we move into this new century. Audience demand is clearly for magic, you know, and magic in film certainly comes at a price. You can't do it. Even a small film will cost more money than most individuals are capable of raising. So there has to be a contract between money and art. There has to be a contract between investment and creation in order to give the consumer choice. Intrinsically, we're not afraid of digital technology. We're afraid of what digital technology could lead to. And on the negative side, clearly piracy is a huge threat. But on the other side, on the more positive side, digital technology for the first time gives us and the consumers the possibility of expressing themselves using moving images in a way that they could never do before. It tended to be in the hands of a priesthood and of alchemists, of which I was one and am one, who are established people able to use the medium to whatever ends we want. What we're looking at is the prospect of a much, much more vibrant cross-cultural energy. And the concern that we have for that is that we must make sure that in every aspect, industrial, legal, political, that everything that can be done to maximize the full benefit of digital technology, not just for the consumer, but also for the creator, so that we're not just dealing with a kind of lowish level YouTube type of activity, but also the higher ends and reaching for what certainly I remember when I started out, what we used to call world cinema, where I could see Hungarian films or Bengali movies or Japanese movies. So I think digital technology is more positive than negative.